Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 16 Beta 4. This is available to developers, and hopefully by the time you're watching this video, it will be out as iOS 16 Public Beta 2. However, if not today, usually it's the following day, so we'll look for that tomorrow if we don't see it soon. Now this came in at 1.67 gigabytes on my iPhone 13 Pro Max, and was about the same size on all the devices we have here, from the iPad Pro to the iPhone 8 Plus, iPhone XR, and iPhone 11. Now along with this, Apple also released Xcode 14 Beta 4, they also released iPadOS 16 Beta 4, macOS 13 Beta 4, tvOS 16 Beta 4, and HomePod OS 16 Beta 4. They did not release watchOS 9 Beta 4, and that's fitting because I forgot to put on my Apple Watch today. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About, and this has changed a little bit where we have the build number here right away. So the build number shows, and if we tap on it, it brings us to that new screen. So you'll see it says this update includes improvements and bug fixes for your iPhone, and you can see the build number is 20A5328H. And this particular update does have a new modem update in it, at least for the 13 Pro Max, bringing us to version 2.08.01. Now, as far as new features, updates, and changes, well, there's quite a few to go over. The first one you can't see just yet has to do with Activity Kit. That was released for the new iOS 16 Live Activities API for developers, which allows them to now use live activities on the lock screen. So if we set a timer on the watch, maybe we'll set a timer here for 10 minutes, hit start, pull down notifications, we have live activities here. Apple showed this in the iOS 16 keynote where we'd have many more like this, such as Uber or Starbucks and more. So now developers can make their apps have this. So hopefully we'll see that fairly soon. Now within Messages is where we get our first new feature or change. Go into Messages, and as you can see, I left a message. However, if we tap on that, we can now see any edits we made. So at first I said this is an iOS 16 Beta 4 test. We see that, then test to see if messages changed. This is an iOS 16 Beta 4 test to see if messages changed. Let's see. And then finally, this is an iOS 16 Beta 4. And you can hide the edits or show them, and you still have 15 minutes to edit them, but Apple has also changed it so you no longer have 15 minutes to undo send. So if we press and hold on this, it's now changed to undo send for 2 minutes. So you can't do that for 15 minutes. This is just for protection. And of course, we also can see those edits now, which is really nice. Wallpaper customization continues to get refinements. If we press and hold, go to customize, hit done, then tap on customize home screen, you can see here they've now labeled what the different options are below: original, color, gradient, photos, or blur. In beta 3 and before, there were no labels there, as you can see, so they've now given us clarification as to what those are. Also, if you're customizing your wallpaper, press and hold, and if you don't have any widgets below your time there, it'll actually now say add widgets, where it wouldn't before. It was just a blank space, so that's something they've updated. And then also, widgets will allow you to customize them further. So if we go into batteries, this is something I didn't mention before that was just discovered, but if you tap on the battery, you can now see that we have options for that specific widget. So it says keep track of the battery levels of your devices, automatic, or turn that off. So that's a little bit different. And then also in this beta, if we go into the clock, they've changed some of the naming. So you'll see here it says City Digital. So on beta 3 on the left, it says City. On the right with beta 4, it says City Digital. The same is true with City Analog, where before it would just say clock. So they've updated some of the naming here just a little bit, but some refinements here and there. Now, if we go to delete a wallpaper, press and hold, we've seen this before, just slide up and now you can delete. But when you tap on delete, it actually says delete this wallpaper. This wallpaper will be removed from both the lock screen and the home screen. So it just says delete this wallpaper. It's a small change, but something that's different. On CarPlay, there's some changes as well. You can see this is a CarPureID device. And if we go over, go into settings, and then we go to wallpaper, there's some new wallpaper. So you'll see we have our typical one, we have a new blue one for day and night, and then we also have some other ones here, more of a black and white version. So you have your regular one from iOS 16, a blue one, and a black and white version. You can see all of the wallpaper available here. If we're playing a song and then we go to our lock screen or our widget in notifications, they've actually changed the way this looks a little bit. The font is a little bit different. You can see here it's actually not saying the album name anymore, and also just looks slightly different. The album art is also larger in beta 4, so it's more edge to edge, as you can see here. And then also, if we go in and maybe play this song, so we'll go in, and if we want to adjust the volume, when you press and hold, the volume slider actually gets a lot bigger, where before it got bigger a little bit, but not a ton. The same is true with the actual slider for going through the track. It gets much bigger as you press and hold to let you know that you've actually pressed on it. So that's a small change. The same is true on the home screen or the lock screen, where you move your thumb, it's just much bigger than it was before. In the home app, we also get additional wallpapers as well. So if we tap on the three dots in the upper right, go to our home settings, scroll down until we see our home wallpaper, tap on choose from existing, you'll see there's two new ones here. Compared to what we had before, we actually have a couple new wallpapers. So some are some blurred flowers and then sort of a wall in the corner and maybe some different blurs here, but nothing really that different, just a couple new added wallpapers. If we go into settings and then go to notifications, they've now added some graphical examples of what these actually mean. So you have count, stack, and list. Before, we actually didn't have those there with beta 3. We had the names, but not sort of a graphical representation of what they actually do. So that's a little different. Also within settings, if we scroll down to Wallet and Apple Pay, at the bottom, we now have an option for notifications. Before, we didn't have that. So there's just a new switch there to turn notifications on or off for Wallet and Apple Pay. Within settings, again, if we go down to accessibility, under accessibility, if we scroll down, we now have control nearby devices. Now we had this before if we triple clicked the power sleep wake button, but now they've made it a separate settings option. So if we go into that, we can control nearby devices and just access this a little bit easier. Also within settings, under Siri and search, Siri call hangup has returned. This was removed with beta 3. It's made its way back with beta 4. So now you can use Siri with your voice to hang up a call. So that's something that they've brought back, and they must have had some issues with it, and now it's returned. If we go into shortcuts, there's some changes there as well, or some fixes rather. Within shortcuts under voice memos, it now says talk to voice memos, hold the home button or say if you have a home button on your device. Before it would just say hold the side button. Now it's corrected depending on the device you actually have. So you'll see on the 13 Pro Max with Face ID, it says hold the side button. So that's just been fixed in this update. Within mail, there's an update. If we go into mail and then slide to the right a little bit, we have archive and remind me. This has been updated compared to beta 3, where it actually says later. So it's a small wording change, but they've updated it from beta 3 to beta 4. Also, if we go into settings and then scroll down to mail, under mail, if we scroll all the way to the bottom, we now have undo send delay. So if you want to undo sending your message, you can actually change that from off 10, 20, or 30 seconds. So it's a new option they added with beta 4. Within the App Store, if we go into the App Store and we tap on our account in the upper right, there's a change. As you can see with beta 3, we have subscriptions. On beta 4, they've removed that and they've just kept it under iCloud where it's always been. So they've removed it from the App Store itself and just put it all in one place. There are also a bunch of new splash screens depending on if you've gone into an app for the first time. So if we take the iPhone XR, which I haven't opened these purposely on, and we go into notes for the first time, we should get a new splash screen that just says quick note on iPhone, more powerful smart folders, remember one less password. Also, we have one in the App Store. So if we go into the App Store, give it just a moment here. We also have a new splash screen saying welcome to the App Store. And also, if we go into Game Center, we have a new one as well. So if we go into our settings, then scroll down, and then go to Game Center, we have a new splash screen that says what's new in Game Center. See all your friends' play activity and achievements on the redesigned dashboard and player profiles. Now, throughout iOS 16 beta 4, there are a ton of different wording changes throughout, little things here and there where they changed some of the wording, and thanks to Steve Mosier for pointing that out to me. Also, a bunch of known and resolved issues remain, tons of resolved issues. Let me show you one of them. If we go into settings and then we go over to our name at the top and then go into iCloud. And if we go into passwords and keychains, keychains, you can see it says securely store your passwords. Prior to this update, there was actually a spelling mistake there. So they've fixed a ton of different things, and we can see those if we go into the feedback app. So if we go into feedback, go to inbox, then go to our beta 4 release notes, you'll see the first thing says users can experience slow animations when using Zoom after leaving the magnifier app. Like I said, there's over 110 different things they've resolved. So vision prescription attachments aren't readable when restored from iCloud. They've fixed that. If we scroll down and keep going, you'll see everything from mail, a bunch of fixes there, to maps, where if a user long presses on the add stop field in route planning, maps quits unexpectedly. Again, they've resolved this. So tons and tons of things they've fixed, but there's also still 17 known issues remaining. So there's definitely still more to fix, but they've resolved more this time around compared to what we had before, where there were a ton of bugs. Now we have more resolved issues. So we've reached the point where much more has been resolved than remains, according to the notes. Now, I know some of you will ask me, have they resolved the storage issues? And so far it seems there's no issue with that. It was resolved in 15.6. It seems like it's resolved here, where it would tell you that you don't have storage available, even if you did. So it looks like it's working okay for me. It's going to load, take just a moment, loads nice and quickly. And typically I tell people to ignore system data, as it can take up a lot and then free itself up if you need more storage. So at this point, it seems like most of that's resolved, but again, let me know if you think there's an issue in the comments below. As far as the phone getting too hot, this time around, it seems to be staying nice and cool. Prior betas, it would heat up quite a bit. It's not too concerning, as they do regulate this with the chip, but it still seems to heat up a little bit. It is slightly warm, but nothing like it was in prior betas, so that's good. As far as iOS 16 public beta 3 and iOS 16 beta 5, I would expect at this point we could be on a weekly release schedule. Now, it's possible they change this up, but we could see a release next Wednesday possibly, or they could push it again 2 weeks until the 10th, but typically we'll have a new release every single week until the final version comes out, usually in mid-September, alongside the iPhone 14, 14 Pro, 14 Plus, and 14 Pro Max. So that's what you can expect as far as that. I haven't heard anything additional about iOS 15.7 or even iOS 15.6.1. I would expect a 15.7 beta as soon as tomorrow, potentially, but Apple could decide they're not going to do that this year. They have done that every year prior, though, where we would have an iOS 15 beta or iOS 14 betas before, up until the end of August with an early September release. We could see that this year, but so far we haven't seen anything. And of course, that leads me to, should you install iOS 16 beta 4? And if you're on beta 3, absolutely. When public beta 2 is out, absolutely install that. If you're on a stable version of iOS 15.6, just make sure you have a backup and you're reporting issues in the feedback app. There can be issues. I've heard of a lot of people downgrading, and I do have a video about that in my description if you need help with doing that. But typically, they seem to be fairly stable as we get further and further on. As far as battery life, we'll talk more about that this weekend with the follow-up video, and battery life typically has not been very good for me on this device with these betas. So battery health is at 100% for me still. I've been using it every single day since it released. Yesterday, I had 8 hours and 43 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 38 minutes of screen off time. So it's getting better, but I still used about 75 to 80% of my battery. Again, we'll talk more about that in future updates this weekend. As far as overall performance, I did run benchmarks and it does seem to be nice and fast on the iPhone 8 Plus. Whether you're going into a different app, be it Minecraft, we'll go into that quickly. And after creating a world, frame rates do seem to be fairly smooth. Oh, there's a little bit of a hiccup, so maybe not as smooth, but it did just load. So it seems okay now if we move quickly. Of course, this isn't the most intensive game. We're going to be trying some new ones in the future here, probably Call of Duty or something else, but we'll talk more about that in future updates. I know I've talked about it a little bit before. As far as overall benchmarks, I did run them on the 13 Pro Max, and if we go into Geekbench, you'll see here I scored 1,723 for single core, 4,667 for multi-core. I ran it twice today, as it was a little bit low the first time, but it actually improved the second time versus the previous beta. So very similar as far as the single core, only 5 points lower, and it's actually higher with the multi-core. So really nothing to worry about. It's performing as you would expect, very similar to Beta 3, which most people said performance wasn't an issue. But there still could be some issues with different apps and things such as banking apps, as people have seen, but it really depends on the app. And so that's everything with iOS 16 Beta 4. Of course, I'm sure we'll find more about this, and I'll have more as far as new features if we find them in a follow-up video later this week. If you found anything, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below, and of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.